What is industrial and systems engineering?
What is industrial and systems engineering?
What?
What is industrial and systems engineering?
So what is industrial and systems engineering? Industrial and systems engineering, or ISE for short, is about figuring out how to make things better. It combines the physical and social sciences together with engineering principles to improve processes and systems. As a result, ISE is the people person's engineering. Industrial engineers improve quality and productivity while at the same time cutting waste like time, materials, money, and energy.
ISE is a combination of engineering and business-minded folks.
In industrial engineering, we look at efficiency in a wide variety of contexts. We study it from manufacturing setups, trying to reduce waste, improve efficiency and productivity in a factory, and then we take it and we go and look at a hospital setting, and we try and improve patient outcomes. Industrial engineering also looks at things like supply chain and logistics, trying to figure out better ways to get the products from the manufacturer to you, the consumer.
And within the ISE major, you learn a lot about tools and skill sets that allow you to go into industry, whether that be nonprofits or B2B or consumer, and figure out how you can reduce the amount of time that they're spending doing things, the amount of resources that they're wasting, or the amount of money that they're spending trying to get to their final product.
I chose ISE here because I really love the faculty and how welcoming our department was.
I actually learned about ISE through one of my summer start mentors. That's a program here at NC State. And she was actually in industrial and systems engineering. And at the time, I was an economics major. And she basically explained it to me as applied economics. So it kind of grabbed my attention and it drove me to gather my own research and try and figure out for myself. And I chose NC State, honestly, because it's in the family. My brother went here and my cousin was a park here. So it was definitely just adding to the wolf pack.
In industrial engineering, we have five different primary research areas that we work in. They are
human systems engineering,
health systems engineering,
advanced manufacturing,
supply chain logistics,
and my personal favorite, systems analysis and optimization.
A successful ISE major wants to have a strong drive for making things more efficient and also a strong passion for statistics.
So really, to be successful with ISE, it's not necessarily about whether you know 100% what you're doing. It's really just the drive and the desire to figure out all the different tools and the different skills that will allow you to achieve that goal.
To be successful here in ISE, you have to be very driven and have the ability to look at the small details while also focusing on the bigger picture at large.
Personally, I think in order to be a successful IE major, you have to have a passion to learn, because usually students who enter this program already have that initial incentive and desire to be efficient and try and get things as quickly as possible. So it's building off of that and willing to expand that mindset and see how you could apply it mathematically and in a more real world setting, and looking at essentially things slightly differently than you did before and having the willingness to expand your general growth mindset.
You can start working on your ISE classes as early as your sophomore year and take hands-on classes during your junior and senior years.
As far as internships and co-ops are concerned, they're not required, but they're definitely a good idea. Many of our students have no problem finding internships and co-ops in a wide variety of industries.
They really give you insight into what you may or may not like about ISE. Since it is such a broad major and you learn so much, it can really help you tailor your ISE experience to you.
It helps you gather skills that you can apply universally, and more importantly, it just changes the way you perceive your classes and just adds to the value of your classes overall.
Some people come to NC State and they didn't even know that industrial systems engineering was offered. They go into mechanical engineering or civil engineering, and then they discover that industrial engineering is really what they wanted to study.
Other engineering disciplines like to call us imaginary engineering, but we all know that's not true. We're the best engineers out there, and we get to work in any field we want.
So a common myth that ISCs have is that the major is less challenging, or that it's a business engineering or a business management engineering, and that therefore it's less challenging. But in reality, ISCs tend to be more people persons, and they're definitely more social than maybe your notorious or stereotypical engineering major. But it's important to know that our major is just as challenging and rewarding, and you requires a lot of attention to detail and overall learning experience.
Industrial engineers work in so many different industries and sectors, with providing so many different jobs, that you're sure to find something that interests you.
It was one of the things that drew me to ISC was the fact that I could pursue so many different avenues of interest.
For me personally, I've worked in like automotive industry, the manufacturing industry, and consulting, and that's just, you know, scraping the surface of what you could do with this degree.
After you join our department, you have numerous ways to get involved. You can join a number of our student organizations.
When you're in the ISC department, you can do undergraduate research with any of our faculty.
Additionally, we have a lot of great study abroad opportunities, from full semester opportunities in places like China to summer sessions led by our faculty in areas from Mexico to the United Kingdom. If you want to do study abroad, research opportunities, or get involved more, ISC is the place for you.